After waiting several hours, the time has come.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is 287, and as always, to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, the video I'm going to do today is entitled Faithful, Not Successful. And that's because I know, as all of you know, those who've watched my videos, at the end of each video, I always say the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. And I believe that wholeheartedly to be true. Now, I was asked, what did I mean by that? And I made a reply to that. And my reply was, I said, easy enough. People have a tendency to count success in things of the world, job, money, home, health, etc. Some even give all the credit to the Father for their blessings in these things, which is acceptable. The reality to myself is that we should count our successes more so in being faithful to Him and keeping His word. There are plenty who aren't blessed in any way with worldly success and things, but find their success in their faithfulness to Him, which brings true blessings. And that's what I believe. Now, I received a reply to that, which essentially says, you said some even give all the credit to the Father for their blessings in these things, which is acceptable. Now, let me stop right there. People oftentimes, whatever they feel they've been blessed with or given, more often than not, people always give that credit to the Father. People always saying, the Father has blessed me, the Lord has blessed me. This takes away from what the enemy can do. If you ask for something long enough, hard enough, do it the wrong way about going about getting it, you can get blessed by the enemy. He can give people all the desires of their heart. Remember, he tried to tempt the Savior himself. Remember the 40 days when the Savior was out and Satan kept coming to him, trying to tempt him. He offered him all the kingdoms of the world. So don't get it confused. The enemy can give you all the desires of your heart. See, if we aren't in the will of the Father, or if we aren't going by what He wants us to do, the enemy is allowed to tempt us in ways beyond our imagination. He will tempt us, and we'll more than likely will succumb to that temptation. When you're out of the will, we lack protection from heaven. So we have to be careful with quickly giving credit where credit may not be due, especially if we're not doing right. So that's why I said that the way I did. But let me continue on. I put and then also then the next line, she says, I want to be successful and don't think God wants us to struggle, and I want to use my success for His glory, not for the world to adore me by it. Like, what's wrong with being successful in the world and not be of the world? I struggle with this because God will bless us in the earth right as long as we don't think we are responsible for it. Well, in all that commentary there, let me point out a few things and where I'm coming from, but I'm gonna go through what scripture says. The next line said, I want to be successful and don't think God wants us to struggle. Well, that's not necessarily true. See, our idea and notion of struggle may not be what His is. See, we may think we're struggling builds character. Struggling can build our faith. If we didn't struggle, if it were easy, none of us would be faithful. We'd all be doing our own thing because it would be too easy. The word tells us we're going to go through trials and tribulations. That's struggling. We're going to go through some struggles. And then on top of all that, we're living in this forsaken place. We're going to go through it. We are going to struggle. You even struggle with success, if not more so, because of success. The next line says, I want to use my success for His glory. There are plenty of people out there who've become successful with that same notion, that they want to use that success to His glory. Scripture even talks about it, and so many fall to the wayside. We have to understand that with success, major responsibility comes with it, and so much more is required from having it, because it is a slippery slope once you become successful. Not many of us can handle that kind of success, especially if it's financial. worldly success. People, when look at the entertainers and the athletes and all that, they are so successful, most of them cannot handle it. They commit suicide. They're always standing in front of a camera apologizing to someone for something. It is not as easy as it seems. We may have the idea that we want to use our success for His glory because it's worldly success, but it may not be what comes from it. But it's a good idea. It's a great idea that we all should think like that. But the question is, can we all handle it? And the answer is no. So that's a tricky one. The next line, she goes, what's wrong with being successful in the world and not being of the world? There's nothing wrong with it if we can pull it off. That's the question within the question right there. And then it says, I struggle with this because God will bless us in the earth, right? As long as we don't think we are responsible for it. And like I said, that's not necessarily true that we're going to get worldly blessings in this earth because we're being faithful. Our faithfulness is to get us into heaven, to become one of His saints. We have to take the view off of this world. See, that's the trap by the enemy. This world as is not what we should be striving for in any sense. Our focus all should be on heaven. Everything we do should be focused and geared toward going to heaven. This world is a stumbling block at best. It gets in the way all the time. But let's go to scripture. Now, Proverbs 28:20 reads, a faithful man shall abound with blessings, but he that maketh haste to be rich shall not be innocent, or shall not go unpunished. So we're getting both sides of the fence right there. A faithful man shall be abound with blessings. So you're going to receive blessings by being faithful. We can't look at blessings as worldly. See, we get caught up in worldly blessings, money, job, things. We have to understand, we have to really open our mind up and accept blessings as they may be. Because everything that we receive that gives us another day is a blessing. Just waking up is a blessing. So we have to always look at everything that He allows us that's not against us as a blessing. And for some, that is success, financial or otherwise, because He knows who can handle that and who can't. I'm not going to presume that I could handle becoming a gazillionaire. I may get caught up and get lost also. So that's something that we don't know. He knows. Now, 1 Timothy 6:9 reads, but they that will be rich fall into what? Temptation. They that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare, and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition. Now, this is what I was talking about. See, many that will be rich, successful, prosperous, fall into that temptation. Being successful is not to be taken lightly. There are so many temptations when you can have and do whatever you want. People, we all, especially us that are unsuccessful, so to speak, we all love to sit back in our strive to be faithful. We'd love to sit back and imagine what we would do to help so many if we had the means, if we had the success to do so. But so many, as they become successful, fall right into that temptation. And worst thing of all is we forget about the Father. We don't just not help all those we claim we would help. We forget about the Father and get caught up in the same world we say that we won't be part of. Success does that. That's the trick of the enemy. We have to be careful with that. And then Proverbs 15:29 tells us why. Greed. Some become greedy. Isaiah 5:8 illustrates that because some just want more and more. There are people that they don't want one house. They buy two, three, four, five. They buy up everything so that they have everything, excess. And then Job 1:19 tells us it brings destruction and perdition to those. So we have to be careful. It is a dangerous slope. Now Luke 12:48 tells us that to whomsoever much is given, shall much be required. We've all heard that if you are giving a lot, there's a lot required of you in this world or otherwise. But if the Father blesses us with much, He's given us more of a responsibility. Now, people take that lightly. They go, same thing. People believe that if I get much, I can do much. But so many turn right around and fall into that trap and don't do what they thought they were going to do. The heart starts to reveal itself. The true character starts to reveal itself. So we can't all assume that we're going to do right by having these things. Prosperity comes with a responsibility, a huge one. This is why all of us aren't prosperous, even if we're faithful. We get blessings in other ways, but prosperity, you know, financially and all that stuff, may not be it. So let's not desire that in terms of success. Faithfulness does not equal wealth, it equals faithfulness. Faithfulness equals faithfulness, and that's what we should be striving for. And whatever comes with it as blessings, we should be grateful and thankful to the Father at all times. Now, let's go to Matthew 19:21 reads, it says, Jesus, Yeshua, said unto him, if thou wilt be perfect, go and sell that thou hast, and give to the poor, and thou shalt have treasure in heaven, and come and follow me. So you remember what I just said, we are to be building up our treasures in heaven. And the Savior simply asked this man, said, are you willing to give up all you have? Go sell it all, give it away to the poor so that they have something, and follow me. And we know that didn't happen. See, so the idea is a wonderful idea, but people will hang on. It's so hard to just let go of everything in this world, because your brain can't rationalize the notion of, I'm gonna have nothing. As just as quick as the Savior says, follow me and you'll have everything, the worldly idea of stuff all being gone, people can't let that go, and they have to hang on to something. So this tests your faithfulness. Our faithfulness is always being tested. Now, in Matthew 6:20, we're told, like I keep saying, we are told to lay up our treasures in heaven. Matthew 6:20. It reads, it says, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. Work hard, work diligently to store and put all our treasures in heaven, because that's where we're striving to go. See, there are plenty who have treasures here on earth, and they're building them and building them and building all their treasures here on earth, because the mentality is, the thinking is, people believe this is where they're going to be. People just forget this is not where we're striving to stay and be. We're only going to be here for a while. So we need to be storing up our treasures in heaven. Look, we have to understand that worldly success is something that's in our mind. It may not be in the plan of the Father's for us, but He will bless us. So let's work on being, like I said, being faithful, and let the blessings come from that. And to close out, Job 1:21 reads, and said, naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked I shall return thither. The Lord gave, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So always bless Him in all things. And with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2Base 7. I'm out.